bear with me. I'm just not fully here on the planet Earth right now. But I want to get this video made and posted to you all, so you might wonder what games still exist. Just to do a test, I used a little bit of money that I have. Well, I have very little money. Wow, redundant. And I went ahead and downloaded a game through the Wii Shop channel today, about a week or 2 weeks after the Switch came out, and it worked. So I'm gonna talk about what I have digitally downloaded on my Wii/Wii U. This is it here. I'm gonna be sipping coffee, trying to stay awake through this. Real quick, a story. At the Game Crazy in Pahrump, which I knew some of the employees there as friends, there was a employee there who, he was fired. He also got arrested and went to jail. He claimed that Microsoft was going to send him a 1 terabyte DVD, which that's actually not possible under the DVD book standards. I forgot which, there's colored books, white book, red book, whatever. And this is, the people who are invested in DVD, created DVD in the past, they publish these books on what can and cannot be done. He said for his Xbox 360, he's going to get a 1 terabyte CD with a bunch of games, and he's a Halo tester and all that. It all ended up being bullshit. And one of the bullshit things he said ended up getting him arrested, and I don't have the full story on that. He also bashed me to my face and said, you know, it's stupid to download all these old games. And I said, you know what? If that's what someone wants to do, that's what someone wants to do. You know, well, who are these? You know what I notice is, this is just an observation. These people who say they aren't fascist or they aren't bossy are the ones who are fascist, bossy bullies. South Park addressed this with their bully episode, if you want to see where what I see that they see. I mean, that's what I see, is that there's these people like this guy. So he doesn't like Virtual Console. He doesn't like WiiWare. Big deal. Okay, his goal when employed is to sell me product. So it's weird in a weird, very weird karmic way that he ended up going to jail for one of his bullshit lies, which somehow he couldn't disprove in court, and that's it. All right. So onto what I own, because I'm going to say right now, I do have a 32 gigabyte SD card, because that's what Nintendo on their 1-800-255-3700 number told me to install, but reality, you don't need more than a 4 gigabyte in the Wii or Wii U. 2 gigabytes will probably get you far if you're not a hardcore player, and you're not downloading a lot of stuff to play. Alright, let's go ahead and get going here. I don't want to take up too much of your time while I'm rambling, which I'm rambling. Alright, so on my first page, now not all the pages are filled up, because this stuff gets put on the Wii U eShop, and eventually the Switch eShop, I'll be taking them off of the regular Wii or Wii U, and that's for simplification. So obviously, you can see that I've been trying to do exercise the wrong way by using both Wii Fit and Wii Fit Plus. Wii Fit Plus is the pinnacle of this software. But I did use Wii Fit for quite a while. And there's Wii Fit Plus. I don't know why they want channels installed here. I don't know what the goal was from the designers. Now, here is a very large game for it. Truth be told, it's 200 megabytes. It's been heavily compressed. Tales of Monkey Island, you know, takes place after, I think, Escape from Monkey Island, which was released on the PS2. So this is the sequel right after it. It's divided up into 5 parts that sell, I believe, for 1,000 points each. That's $10. You know, that's actually a $50 game, which is a normal price game. Anything from $40 to $60 is a normal price game. If you go above $60, it doesn't make any sense. Then I have Bejeweled 2. People have seen me play this video. It seems to be a it's a popular video by my numbers, but, you know, I'm not saying not popular by YouTube numbers, but people are watching it, so I'm grateful for that. Right there is TV Show King 1 and 2. 2 is not as good as 1. 1 got an update, and this is the updated version. I don't have the original version in it. So the questions and some bugs were worked out. That's Dracula X Rondo of Blood, or as we just like to call it, the TurboGrafx version of Dracula X. And then there's Castlevania Rebirth. Castlevania the Adventure Rebirth. It doesn't look anything like Castlevania the Adventure on Game Boy, which I have on my 3DS and the original cartridge. I played that on an episode of Grumpy Bear Play, just the one that's chopped up into 10 minutes with Game Boy. Next, I have Samurai Showdown 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, this sounds a little weird. I'm fond of Samurai Showdown on my 3DO. I'm fond of Samurai Showdown 2 on a Windows 95 computer, because that's what I have it for. When I play that on Windows 10, the screen is very, very, very small. I'm fond of Samurai Showdown 3 on the PlayStation, but I gave that version away because it is a bad version, and I do have it on Saturn. And I thought, well, I would enjoy it on Saturn, but there's something not right about the Saturn version. There's something weirdly right about the PS3 version. Maybe it's the same game, or this would be better because this is an emulation of the original. There's just some charm that the PlayStation Sony-released version of Blades of Blood, that's what it's called, it's just, there's something about it that just makes it more fun. And then there's Samurai Showdown 4, which I also had on the Saturn. I don't really recall it being a good version on the Saturn. I have more fond memories of playing that before its Saturn release at the Mary Kay's Arcade. Then I have Splatterhouse and Splatterhouse 2. You might have seen these videos done for Halloween. That's when I played these two games. Surprisingly, the excellent Splatterhouse 3 is not available. There you go. The game, the 1 is okay, 2 is okay, and 3 is excellent. So, following up, I have SimCity from Nintendo. This is probably the best version, in my opinion, of SimCity, the original SimCity. Followed up by SimEarth, which for reasons unknown is not the Super NES version, the TurboGrafx version. I don't know why. Both versions of the game were very similar, but the Super NES version of SimEarth, I believe, is a better, visually better version of the game. And then surprisingly, they could have released SimCity 2000 for Super NES or N64, but they chose not to, so that's not on here. But I do have SimCity 2000 for GOG. It's free. Let's see, Frogger Returns. That's an okay version of Frogger. It's nothing spectacular. It is what it is, what it is. Really, Konami and Hasbro, Atari, or Infogrames, I need to all sit down and figure out a way to get that PlayStation version of Frogger out. There's another version by Konami called Hyper Arcade Edition. It's just Frogger with Tron-looking graphics, or Contra-looking graphics, or Castlevania-looking graphics. It's not that great. Then next up, now this is not the order I bought the games in. I don't know what order I bought the games in. This is just the way they're going to be. I do have the order list. You can get that from the pen. Next up is Mega Man 9. Too hard. The game is just too hard. Now, you've seen my problems with the first Mega Man, and if I keep trying like a rabid dog, I will beat the level. And that's the same with Mega Man 9. It is that kind of hard. It's Nintendo hard. But followed by the ridiculously easy Mega Man 10. Both are excellent games, especially for WiiWare. I did buy all the extra options and stuff. I think they're like 200, 300 Wii shop points, whatever like that. That's pretty cool in my opinion. Well, I follow up now with Booger Man, a pick and flick adventure. I forgot how good the game actually is. I do recommend anyone who wants a unique game, go ahead and get Boogerman. I don't know why it's the Genesis version over the Super NES version. And I'm also, correct me if I'm wrong, but wasn't Pitfall the Mayan Adventure also out on Virtual Console? Because I would have, if it was, I would have bought it. I don't know if it was or wasn't. Next is the Mario Kart channel. I have no idea why this exists. I have no idea why Nintendo made it. I don't know, other than me, I don't know anyone else who made this channel, or if they do make the channel, they just don't use it. It's straight to the disc. Oh, a little confusion there. Now for some nostalgia, there's the original Final Fantasy. To be honest, I haven't gotten very far on this version. I don't have an NES Classic yet. So, I don't know which version I'll be playing more. Probably this one, if I wanted to record. But then I have both systems would be rigged up to record. So. Truthfully, I'll play it on the PS3. Final Fantasy... Anthology? No, Origins. Final Fantasy Origins. Which, then there's Final Fantasy 2, which is actually 4. And that's the Super NES version, followed by Final Fantasy 4, the After Years. Which I have not, on this version, I have not bought everything that goes with it. And the reason being is plain and simple. I bought it on PSP, and that's the version I play. It has the entire, it says the After Years Complete, or Final Fantasy 4 Complete, or something like that. I did play the After Years, the first quest, and don't have to buy something to download. That was good. Final Fantasy Mystic Quest. This is a game, this is my only memory of the game. I don't actually, I do remember playing it, but I don't remember situations or anything. That goes for a lot of games. My brain is just fried, especially today. Final Fantasy Mystic Quest. I remember my friends and I were talking in 94, so about 3 years after its release, 2 years after its release, we're like, oh yeah, we all have like, was it 90 or 99 hours or something like that. And the masterpiece that is Final Fantasy VI, but called 3 here, that to me is pretty much perfect, except for, it does the He-Man world in the right way. From 7 and up, 7 is just a graphical powerhouse. It's kind of a crappy game. I know people are like, oh, Final Fantasy VII, Final Fantasy VII. Get off your high horses, people, and get in reality. Final Fantasy VI or 3, as it would be here on the Wii Shop channel. That's Final Fantasy. It's called Final Fantasy VI Advance. I'll buy the game. Really, really damn good. It's, to me, it's just perfect as far as that kind of RPG goes. Everything just fell into place. Final Fantasy, Crystal Chronicles, My Life as a King. SimCity meets Final Fantasy. And here plays a young king who manages a town by building houses and stuff, setting up quests. The players go on a quest. They then get experience and everything. The player, myself, would have no control whatsoever over the events of the villagers, as I simply hire them. And then I can also put the assistant in the bikini and talk to Moogle. My Life is Dark Lord, also another Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles. Now, I have not finished downloading all the scenarios for this particular game. And I have to say, it's nowhere near as fun as My Life as King. Secret of Mana. And there's an H in there, I'll say it the other way, but right now it's Mana. Okay? Not two N's either, so. It's a rather more Zelda-esque game. I like how Moogle and Santa Claus are involved, and I was totally bitching at defeating the last guy at the end of the game. Also known as, I think, the Final Fantasy Adventure 2? Or whatever that's called. Or I had that wrong. I'm somewhere in there. There's obviously Chrono Trigger, so if you want to pick up an easy-to-get version of Chrono Trigger and these Square RPGs right here, I recommend just going to the Wii Shop channel and doing it. And if you need your Wii up converter, go buy an HDMI converter. Or if you have it on your Wii U, just do it on the Wii U mode. And you don't have to have a memory card if this is just what you want to play. If you just want to play Final Fantasy 2, Final Fantasy IV, The After Years, Mystic Quest, Final Fantasy III, Secret of Mana, and Chrono Trigger, then you don't need an SD card. These will fit easily onto the internal RAM. That measly half gigabyte. Well, we have actually less than half a gigabyte to use from the Nintendo. There's ActRaiser, in itself a masterpiece. So that's, and really, just play ActRaiser. You'll see what I mean. It has rough edges, because it was a first-generation Super NES type. And, yes, there's no such thing as a gaming generation. Go by eras. This household, not Wikipedia. And also, ActRaiser is part of a generation. The first generation is the first 365 days of the system. Like, Final Fantasy 2 or 4 is called, is also part of it. Next up is the not as good as carbonated games, Uno, but a decent version of Uno. It was fun playing both versions online. When I do the 360 game, you'll see the other version. I did do a video of this Uno. This is also no longer available. So it's the same version of Uno on DSiWare, also no longer available. In order to get, I don't know how to get Uno on the Wii, but in order to get Uno on a 3DS or a DSi or any DS, just buy this Uno Skip Bow, Uno something, Uno Skip Bow. There's another Uno on there. That's the Uno to buy. I had to buy that so my wife could have Uno. VIP Casino Blackjack. That's exactly what the tin says. It's Casino Blackjack. And unless you like playing blackjack, I've got to say, playing blackjack in person, playing it on a slot machine, and playing it here, this is the least satisfying blackjack. But the game is not programmed poorly or anything. Just, yeah. Maboshi's Arcade from Club Nintendo. Redeemable game. Really didn't enjoy it. And in fact, it's forgettable. Arcade Essentials, I think they have like a Walkout Wannabe, a Bust-A-Move Wannabe, and so forth and so on. This is something I could have gotten away with 30 years ago, 35 years ago, in like Atari Vico or something like that. But then again, each one of these things would have been sold at an individual game. That, and it's all over. It's also on PSP, I think, and PS Vita, PS3. Not really that much fun. They've dotted all the I's and crossed all the T's. The game itself just is not a fun collection, just not done in a fun way. Drill Off with Ultra Hand, and that was free for Club Nintendo members, I think. Or it was 80 points, real cheap. The idea is to take Gopei Yokoi's Ultra Hand. It's a toy he invented for Nintendo in the 60s, I think, early 70s. And it's really hard. It's not a fun game. It's too hard. I would rather just buy a real Ultra Hand for a few $100s, thanks to this game that went up in price. From the toy. I used to have one as a kid. I used to get a lot of toys from Korean, Chinese, and Japanese Vietnamese markets as a child. Next up is another Club Nintendo game, Doc Lewis's Punch-Out. This is just fighting Doc Lewis. In a way, some kind of weird hidden character of Punch-Out. This wasn't available on Club Nintendo that often. It was pretty rare to get it. So when Club Nintendo was going out, Nintendo offered it again. So I went ahead and I used up as much of my points as I could to go ahead and get things I didn't know. Another one of those would be Excite Bike World Rally. It's exactly what it is, Excite Bike. It's not a sequel to Excite Bike 64, though. Excite Bike 64 might think it's a sequel. It's Excite Bike with just updated graphics. Not as fun as the original Excite Bike. Fast Racing League is the prequel to. I guess it's called Fast Neo Racing or something. This is fast, but it lacks polish. It's too fast. It's impossible to control. And all the errors that were in this version were by Shinden completely corrected all of it fast enough. If you don't have a Wii U, yeah, I recommend it. It'll take hours of practice to, like, Extreme G 1 and 2 to finally get control of these bikes. In fact, it's more touchy than those. It's more touchy than Gran Turismo, which I call Gran Turismo. Play that, you'll know why. The minute you touch a blade of pixelated grass on a game, you'll see that your car is spinning out of control. That doesn't happen. I've watched plenty of auto races. Gotta be mostly the whole tire. Arkanoid Plus. I also bought the expansion pack for that. I enjoy Arkanoid, and I can play Arkanoid all day. It's Breakout with a Plot. And Arkanoid is... when things are just down and bad, there's nothing like coming back to Arkanoid. Alright, there's some game there, so let's find out what it is. As soon as I can get this. There we go. Orbeez. Must have been a real long time since I played Orbeez. Is it a shooter? I think it's a shooter. No. Cool Revolution Q Sports. Me and Phil Barnes, the other YouTuber, we played the hell out of this game. I wish we taped some of the things we did. I wish I was more involved with YouTube in the beginning, but they didn't have the Creative Commons license, so... The reason we stopped playing Cool Revolution was simply because we bought a pool table. We went 50-50 on a pool table that we're not even using anymore. Next is Contra Rebirth, a really good version of Contra, but really, really hard. That's all I can say about that. It's Contra. It's Rebirth. Buy it. Buy Contra. Here's a game I have on PS2, but I think I sold it recently. Okasto Fishing Master. Wife wanted it. Never has ever played. I have never played it. I did buy it for me. I bought it for her. She has her own Wii U. Before that, she had her own Wii in red. We ended up with a second Wii. And she has never, ever played this game. There's a handful of games like that. She's like, oh, I want this, I want that. She never plays it. This seems to be endemic mostly to Americans. Not of a particular race, creed, color, or religion. Just, I would say it's a 50-50 split with the population. There's people like me that if I buy something, I'm going to use it. And there's people who get something or buy something and they don't need it. And people are right there. It's a 50-50 split. Why have something if you're not going to use it? I mean, I find DVDs I didn't buy. I bought not open. I just opened them to take them to see a record and trade them. She didn't want the movie. She obviously didn't want the movie, but she certainly wanted to give the movie company some money or the retail store. Next is Fast Draw Showdown. Phil Barnes is really good at this game. I am okay. They call the guy main sheriff character Earl. Now, remember, this is can't be crammed into any more than 40 megabytes. So they did some heavy compression. That's a LaserDisc game. A WiiWare. Pretty impressive. Tetris Party. Fellow YouTuber Matt Murphy and his older sister were watching me play that. The whole time I'm lecturing about how to play Tetris, I know. 15 levels of Tetris. Dark Gage, another YouTuber, he actually beat the balance board version of Tetris all. Followed by Dr. Mario Pharmacy Online. I don't know, it's not really an RX, some kind of weird pharmaceutical symbol. I don't know what it means. But anyways, that one I used to play online with, and so did my wife. After a while, we just don't. We don't do anything. I fucking hate the iPad, and before that I hated the iMac because it took people off the game system. Put them on things that shouldn't be running games. Your opinion may differ, that's fine, but I do have games on my iPad. And I do have games on my computer. Does that make me hypocritical, or does that just make me a better manager of time for people? I don't know. Next is Dracula the Awakening. Piece of crap. Yeah, you know, I don't mean any any ill will towards programmers, but, you know, that game, the pictures look like it would be fun. Like a Smash TV meets Dracula kind of thing, and no. Next is Defend Your Castle. Almost everyone I know has this for some reason. It's like the one WiiWare game that everyone has. Defend Your Castle. Really didn't care for it. I don't even remember how to play it. But I did play it. I actually did play quite a bit. Family Table Tennis. I bought that when we had roommates. Let her play that. So no one plays it anymore. Not Pong, that's for sure. It's not easy either. It's not bad, it's not good. It might have appeal overseas in the anime style. Ben 10, Rise of Hex. I did a video that was released on Christmas of the takeoff. Either no one can find me on YouTube, or Ben 10's not as popular as everyone thinks. No longer available on the eShop, Wii Shop channel. It was released by Konami. It's an okay game, but it looks like either an early PlayStation Saturn game. Hell, it could have been done in the 16-bit. Not really that great. Onslaught. Onslaught's a fun first-person shooter where you have to use both the nunchuck and the Wiimote. You gotta wipe off stuff. Gunk that comes up from the bug. There's very little plot, just a lot of heavy action. That's what a first-person shooter is. I do play Fantasy Slots a lot because I like to chill out. But my one drawback with Fantasy Slots has got to be active with the bonus games. And if you've ever been to a casino in Las Vegas or wherever they have these, you know, games like Texas T or that's the only one I can think of. Lobster Mania, stuff like that. The games here are on par with that, except there's too much interactivity with them all. Step Up. Bought that again for the roommate's daughter. Played it once, fell off the balance board, cried, and played again. My Dolphin tickles and dimes people to get things on it. That's a drawback. And plus, the virtual pet things, I don't know. They get to be a hassle. Unless a person has absolutely no form of entertainment but a Wii. And no computer, no cell phone, no nothing. They have a home phone, they have a radio, TV, and a Wii. Then this would be entertaining. Now I have Lode Runner. This is the version of Lode Runner I grew up playing, but it's not as good as I remember. Now I heard, let me hear this from James Rolfe, I don't think it was James Rolfe. This Lode Runner, this particular version of it, ties into Milan or Milan's Secret Castle, which then ties into Magical Do-Re-Mi, which is Magical Do-Re-Mi Fantasy, which has nothing to do with Do-Re-Mi from the kids' WB. Or the CW for digital. It's a competent version of Lode Runner, I will give it that. And it is a good version of Lode Runner, I'll also give it that. It's just, it's dated. Battle Lode Runner? More like Battle Bomberman meets Lode Runner. Never could get into this game with my friend. We tried. We haven't played it in almost 10 years, I would say. No, that's fair to say. We haven't played it in a decade. Bubble Bobble made a video, released that on Christmas or Thanksgiving. I think Thanksgiving because of eating. And there you go, it's Bubble Bobble. You want a good version of Bubble Bobble? There you go. And you don't have to worry about the NES crapping out on you, which is actually common with Bubble Bobble. Bust a Move Plus. Hey, and get the extra levels, including the original levels. There you go, you got a good version of Bust a Move. The only thing is the music has changed, and I really don't like it. I need to mention that this Arkanoid, Bust a Move Plus, and then there's a game Bubble Bobble Plus, which I haven't bought yet. All these games, are also available on PS3 and Xbox 360, with slightly different titles, but the same looking logos and titles. Then there's Alien Crush. This is a pinball game, a pretty good one, that has obvious Ridley Scott, James Cameron, Geiger, H.R. Geiger, Aliens as inspiration, followed by its sort of sequel, Devil's Crush, which is also pretty competent. Not as good as Alien Crush. There is a third Alien Crush game that I haven't bought yet. There's Airzonk, and then there's a second Airzonk. Super Airzonk. Oh, well, okay, there you go. Both are very good shooters. They were called Zonk because they're supposed to be related to Bonk, but whatever. My wife likes the Airzonk game. Then there's Bomberman 93. That, again, is a really good Bomberman game. I always thought it came out on Super NES, but, you know, maybe I'm wrong. I'm thinking of Super Bomberman or Mega Bomberman. But if you want a good Bomberman game, there it is. Bomberman 93. I think Bomberman 94 is still available. I think there's another Bomberman that's available also in the WiiWare section. So go ahead and check out Bomberman. The King of Fighters 99. I bought that. That was my test download. Can't get anything less than $10 due to the Wii point. Should have updated that eons ago. Anyways, there it is, the King of Fighters 99. It downloaded fine, so everything's perfect. That's the only, that game is not available on the Orochi Collection, which is available on PS2, PSP, and regular Wii. I went ahead and bought that to complete my collection. Two Burger Time games. The original Burger Time and Burger Time World Tour. Though that's the NES version, it plays plays better than any other version. I do like that. And Burger Time World Tour, that's been delisted, and then it came back, and then it got delisted again, and I think it came back one more time. So it may or may not be on the eShop channel. I really enjoyed that also. It's a unique take on Burger Time. It requires a little bit of strategy, a little bit of thought, with practice. And the skills needed to time your burgers. Next up is the Master System version of Fantasy Zone. That is actually, in my mind, replacing the Tengen version I have on the NES. I heard there were two versions released for the NES hardware, one on Famicom and one by NES by Tengen. Either way, this is the Sega version, which I never owned. Next up is the Awful China Warrior. Now, with a title screen like that, Bruce Lee looking guy, you're thinking, yeah, that's what I was thinking. Yeah, this is going to be a good game. It's garbage. It's garbage. Let's just leave it at that. It's garbage. Echo the Dolphin. You know, I can't get past the first leveling. It's pretty weird. There's an old VHS tape recording of me. I had it on Sega CD. I might be incorrect on that, but I think I had Echo the Dolphin on Sega CD. Beyond Oasis, a Zelda-style... I wish they would release Crusaders of Senti. But, or Kenti. I'm gonna go with Senti because it looks like... Yeah. Talking about Beyond Oasis here. On my original Genesis cartridge, I had no problem getting into this game, but here on the Wii, I don't think I want to go through the whole journey. I just don't play it here. I just play the original Genesis cartridge. There's Cruisin' USA, and the last Cruisin' game just called Cruisin'. You want to know what the Cruisin' games are? Cruisin' USA, Cruisin' World, Cruisin' Exotica, Cruisin' Velocity, Cruisin'. They're all cruising for a bruising, but this one's pretty good. I wish they also had the two other ones. Cruising World is almost arcade perfect on the N64. Eurocom really, really did a good job, whereas the original programmers worked on this version. That includes the programmer from Nintendo, middle, and the third or fourth part, the second part of their Eurocom. Trying to do the tweaks and stuff for it. It's not arcade perfect. Bloody Wolf, this is a weird top-down running gun that's not any good. Blazing Lasers is a decent shooter, but that's all it is a shooter. And this came out at a time when shooters shooters weren't really seen as something that should sell a system unless it's like a spectacular shooter. Blazing Lasers is not. Especially when compared to Air Zombies, Super Air Zombies. This one is not. This one is just right in the middle type of shooter. I don't even know if I'd play it if there was an arcade machine on it. Next is Bravo Man. Don't remember anything about it. It's probably been a decade since I played it. Then there's Super Smash Bros. For N64. And then there's got to be the worst version of Smash Bros. I just never get used to the controls on it. I have no problem with Smash Bros. On GameCube, no problem with Smash Bros. On Wii, and no problem with Smash Bros. On Wii U or 3DS. The original N64 version, just can't control it. My brain and the control scheme just don't mesh or something. That's Denta Twin B, or Daytona Twin B. Daytona Twin B. And I think it's the prequel to Poppin' Twin B, which they should have brought over. It's very good. It's a very good shooter, especially when compared to Bloody Blazing Lasers. And next up is Doremi Fantasy, and that's Mylon right there. And not as bad as Mylon's Secret Castle, but nothing to write home about. It's just a run-of-the-mill platformer. Now, getting into, I have Bonk's Revenge. Really, regular Bonk. That's interesting. Well, anyways, I have Bonk's Revenge and Bonk 3, Bonk's Adventure. Bonk, I know that his NES and Super NES games are valuable for the douchebag collector, but seriously, Bonk games aren't any good. I don't know how to put that. Hudson Soft would have been better off. See, Hudson, they're outright owned by Konami. Now they're fully owned by Konami. Actually, completely dissolved as a company. And Hudson had Bomberman, Bonk, Mylon, Zonk, Heat Courage. There's a whole bunch of characters they had as mascots. I think Bomberman, or even Mylon, and he also had Master Higgins from Adventure Island series. These games, they're not bad games, but once, no reason to come back. That's what hurt TurboGrafx. Two-Man Foo. I think, if I'm right, this is a top-down semi-puzzle game where I go around the martial arts of it all. Another run-of-the-mill, mediocre game. Star Parodier, consider it a competing, I don't know why, it's the closest you're going to get to the excellent Parodia series in America. It's not made by the same team, it's made by Hudson. Bomberman, Mr. TurboGrafx 16, and I think one other character, and going around through these hilarious levels and events, and it's unfortunately not listed right now for sale, but if it does come up, or hell, if you're really serious about playing one of the best shooters ever made, go ahead, import yourself a Japanese TurboGrafx CD, and go ahead and get this game. That damn good. Hoopa. Something something baby Hoopa. Hoopa made his 16-bit appearance in G. Parodius on the Super NES, Super Famicom. I think it's called Nonsense Fantasy, Fantastic Journey, Nonsense Fantasy in Europe. And he also, I don't know too much about him. Koopa's a good game. It's a little tough, so it requires a little bit of brain power. But with practice comes skill. Chase HQ. If you don't know what Chase HQ is, I'll explain it real quick. I'm going to be rude and say nothing, but I'll explain it real quick. You're a cop. You use your car to apprehend suspects, better than ATV by a party, by running into the car. It's had a handful of sequels. I think NES, Super NES, Genesis, and I believe it's been in a few collections. Chase HQ, here I have it. A lot of fond memories in the arcade. Man, considering I never had a home version of the game, when I bought this, I didn't enjoy it. I probably haven't played this in a decade. Dead Moon, another mediocre shooter from our friend Hutchinson. Clay Fighters. Completed the theme song of the Super NES version. Baffled why they would even release this Genesis version. The Genesis version has excellent control. Awful graphics. Awful sound. But why not release the Super NES version called, I think it was called Champion Edition or something like that. I actually made videos from it. I do own this cartridge. As weird as that is, I do own that version of Clay Fighter. I gave away my original Super NES version of Clay Fighter to a nephew. So, I am baffled by this version of Clay Fighter, why it's still up for sale, but there it is if you want to take a look. It's still humorous. Like I said, the play control is really good. Fighting Street is the first Street Fighter game as bad as everyone says it is. No. No, these are just people who don't want to sit there and figure out the scheme, the control scheme. It's actually a pretty good fighter, especially when considering it was released originally in the arcades in 1987, and this one I think came out on TurboGrafx in 1990. I have the Japanese version myself because there's no region lockout on the CD game. It's called Fighting Street, and I do enjoy it. I really like this version because it remembers my high school, and I can also stop it and resume it later. Earthworm Jim, again, the Genesis version over the Super NES version. I believe Earthworm Jim HD is available on the Xbox 360, and I also believe that there's this version of Earthworm Jim on DSiWare. Earthworm Jim is something that seems like it has appeal. The game has, the controls aren't the greatest or anything. It has good animation, good graphics, pretty good plot, actually. To keep the story going, everything, but to me, it's not this, it's not that great of a game. It has flaws. It's a 7 on a 10 scale. And those flaws is what knocks it down to that, in my opinion. Now, next up is Super Baseball 2020. Well, I'll explain. Super Baseball 2020 is the game I take with me whenever I'm on a cruise ship. I will not go, well, not just a cruise ship, any ship. I do not go anywhere without my Genesis Super Baseball 2020, or the 2020 Super Baseball cartridge. This is the Neo Geo version. I also have this on the Neo Geo X Gold system, which I'm thinking about getting rid of. But this is a good game, and it's one of the better baseball games, really, especially with Super. Just thought I would mention that. Now, Sonic the Hedgehog, the first one is a Genesis version that we all know and love. The second one is the Master System version, which is more of a Mario-esque platformer than anything. Not as much running. Then there's Sonic 2. And next to it is Sonic 2 for the Master System. And there's... which is not as good as Sonic 2 on the Genesis, though it's not a bad game. That's what I need to stress. Master System Sonic are good games. They're just not in the league with their Genesis counterparts. Their Sonic Spinball, that's just not in league with anything. It's not fun. It's not a good pinball game. That's what really harms it. And it's not a good Sonic game. And then there's Sonic the Hedgehog 4. I don't have 3. That's interesting. I wonder why. Sonic the Hedgehog 4, that's just episode 1. I have episode 2 on the Xbox 360. Why they never released it is probably they couldn't compress it down to the 40 megabytes required for WiiWare. This is not a good Sonic game either. It's a little bit baffling. It's like Double Dragon 4 recently. Yeah, 4 would be the trend here. It just lacks charm. Rystar is a... requires a little bit of strategy. It's from Team Sonic. It's like Knights of the Dream. And it's alright. It's entertaining. Yeah, play it maybe 3 times at the most, though. It's about as good as replayability goes. Fatal Fury, King of Fighters. And Fatal Fury Special. Notice I don't have 2, 3. Mark of the Wolves. I don't have any of that here. I just have Fatal Fury and Fatal Fury Special. Fatal Fury is just too damn hard. The original Fatal Fury is just too damn hard no matter what version of the game I have. I know the moves. it's just a hard game. Fatal Fury Special, I got more of a chance on it, and that's why I actually enjoy it. I do have Fatal Fury Special also on Xbox 360. And for some reason, this Virtual Console version, well, I have to agree with RetroCore, Mark Smith. There's just some charm about the Sega CD version that makes it better than all the other versions. Carmen San Diego, these are mathematical capers. Bought Chapter 1 and Chapter 4. Wonder why the story didn't mesh. I didn't realize I bought Chapter 4. So I need 2, 3, and I think it goes up to 6. That is the last game in the Carmen San Diego game series. I think if there's 6 chapters, it's a $60 game. If there's 5 chapters, I think it's a $50 game. I could be completely wrong on all of that, but like Monkey Island, it's divided up into chapters, and here we go. Prince of Persia, the Super NES version. This one gives 2 hours, and the levels are expanded and everything. It's supposed to be the version of the original Prince of Persia to end all other versions. Truthfully, the best version, in my opinion, is by Tengen on the Genesis. And the other good version is the Game Gear version by Domark or Tengen, I forgot who. And TurboGrafx CD version and the Sega CD version. Those are all good versions. Speaking of Carmen San Diego again, excellent versions of Carmen San Diego on the Master System, NES, Super NES, Genesis. There are Carmen games if you want that there. But this version of Prince of Persia is more of an expansion pack, and it's not as fun. Though graphically, musically, everything is right, well, that's where it ends. Ninja Gaiden. This is the arcade version. Can only be beat with 2 players. You know that, didn't you? There's Quarter Sucker at the end, beating the transvestite leather guy. I think he's a transvestite. I'm not positively sure. He's definitely in the leather, I'll say that. And this, a lot of people have complaints. I think the arcade version is the version I've always wanted. I like this game. I even have it on the Atari Lynx, which is an adventure in and of itself. I'm not going to talk about what I went through to get it on the Lynx. But yes, this is the version I've always wanted as a kid. And imagine my disappointment when that ridiculously Nintendo hard version of the game. The only cool part was the anime cutscene. God Plus, the sequel to Galaxian and Galaga, I guess, or something like that. Whatever. Typical Space Invaders type shooter from Namco. Not that great. Magician Lord. Maybe I got fond memories or something, because this just wasn't as good. Lunar Pool. I haven't touched that game in a decade. Maybe less, maybe 5 years. Disappointed. I believe I got that through eSports, or I mean Club Nintendo Redemption. I know I did that for NES Play Action Football. I did enjoy that, but it is a football game. It's fun with 2 people. I can't sit there and explain to people how to play it, so I don't bother. That's some Japanese game. Sansan? I don't know. I like it. I enjoy it. My wife even played it. Darius Twin, one of the better shooters available on the eShop channel. I do recommend people get that game. XX's, whatever. It is what it is. I don't really think I enjoy it that much. Elevator Action. This is actually a good version of the game, so I do recommend that. Soldier's another one like XX's. And Gunstar Heroes I don't enjoy either, so I can definitely see where it is a masterpiece of its own right. I can just never get into it. And no, I've never owned the Genesis cartridge. That's why it's here. Ogre Battle. And a friend of mine has a Super Famicom version of the game. He had a huge, like, translation Bible with it. This one, I had the actual Super NES cartridge. The battery is gone. Actually, I sold the cartridge, so before I sold the cartridge, the battery wasn't holding my save anyway. I always wanted to get back into it, never had. Utopia 2, the sequel to Utopia, which is the TurboGrafx answer to Zelda. No joke. And the Utopia games are competent RPGs. You But the problem is, I don't care about the characters. Super Star Wars, Super Empire Strikes Back, Super Return of the Jedi, and Indiana Jones, the fourth game in the series. I'll explain. Amazing. Sculpture Software, I think. Super Star Wars is on PS4. I did do a stream of it. Let's see that. These are okay games. There's nothing spectacular about them. They're not bad games. They're actually pretty good games. It takes a lot of practice and know-how. What's weird is I thought I was crazy. I thought Super Star Wars was really hard until I actually checked my saves on these. And I actually own, I don't own Indiana Jones, but I own the other three on the Super NES, meaning I probably played the hell out of them as a child. Zombie Ate My Neighbors and Ghoul Patrol. Ghoul Patrol was released by JVC, which is a sequel to Zombie Ate My Neighbors, released by Konami, but they're actually LucasArts games, which means they're Disney fans. They're top-down shooters that have the joking horror theme about them. Zombie Ate My Neighbors was also released on the Sega Genesis. And these games are fairly good, but they're not as good as I remember, so, you know, nostalgia filter there. Golden Axe, that's the Mega Drive version. Genesis version. The reason I said Mega Drive is because I own the Mega Drive version. Also available on Sega CD. Golden Axe 2. Golden Axe 2 was, it's a cocky sequel, what I mean. Like, okay, we're here. You know everything. Let's get going. And it really doesn't try to go above and beyond the original Golden Axe, though it does have those advantages and techniques because it did come out later, and the programming team that did it was more familiar with the Genesis hardware than the straight-up conversion. You were working with the hardware to get them. Golden Axe 3 is a travesty. It's just poor. I don't know. It's like Double Dragon 3. It's just bad. Gate of Thunder, sometimes called Gates of Thunder, another TurboGrafx shooter. And this one goes above and beyond the quality of what a shooter should be. This is an excellent shooter. I do believe that it has a sequel called Lords of Thunder, or Lord of Thunder, which is available on Sega CD, as well as maybe for download somewhere. But you can be here on the Wii Shop channel. Phantasy Star is the first one. This is also available on Phantasy Star. Phantasy Star. I have to say that Phantasy Star has always been like this inelegant, well, I have a Genesis, I guess I should play this RPG attitude. Well, Phantasy Star 4, which is called the End of the Edit. While it is inelegant in places, it's a fucking masterpiece, especially when compared to Final Fantasy at the time. It was competent and stand up on its own merits and design. But Final Fantasy 2 and 3, if you notice, that's weird. I do have Final Fantasy 2. Why is it not here? I gotta go re-download. Why would there be a gap between Final Fantasy Star and Star 4? I know I don't have 3. You know that. But I, well, let me take that back. I have Fantasy Star's original Genesis cartridge. I don't have Phantasy Star on Master System, but I have the Phantasy Star collection, so I got these games twice over. Legend of the Hero Tonma. Don't even bother. I'm not going to bother. I haven't played that in probably a decade or a year. Gradius 2. We finally get it. I always thought Life Force, the Salamander, sometimes calling for Gradius 2, but this is the Gradius 2, just as hard as I remember it. Ninja Spirit. This is a pretty decent game for a one or two playthrough. Not that great. Not bad. It's just kind of in the middle. Play as a ninja and you go around defeating evil spirits. It's similar to Legend of Kage. Or Legend of Cage, as it's called in the show. Galaga 90. I think it was called Galaga 88 or 91. Anyways, this is a good version of Galaga. It's a good translation from the arcade machine it's based on. But it is its own game. It's not not Galaga. Galaga is Galaga. Galaga will always be Galaga. This is a sequel to Galaga. Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. Be honest, my wife downloaded it, never played it, and I've never played it. Secret Commando. Now, first you think, maybe it's a sequel to Capcom's game. No. It's Rambo on the Master System, the first Rambo game. Oh. It actually see the arrow and the machine gun and the icon. Oh. Critter Roundup is a puzzle game. It's really good. I recommend it. Where the player goes around boxing in animals and trying to keep out the bad animals from eating them. Protothea is an Ubisoft shooter. It's just a shooter. There's no other way around it. It's a shooter. It's a good shooter. I recommend it, but I can't. At the same time, I can't recommend it. What do we have here? Cubello. Know anything about it. Oh, sorry. Must be one of my wife's games. Lost Lens. I keep saying Just Lens. Doesn't that look like Just, not Lost? Lost Lens is a very good platformer. It also has a sequel. Sometimes they're delisted, and sometimes they're available on the Wii Shop channel. Is that Tower Toppler? I think it's Tower Toppler. You play this little dinky thing that goes up the tower. Art of Fighting. Art of Fighting, as you know, is a related series to Fatal Fury. All of these got united. And sometimes they go off and make their own games, but they all got united under the King of Fighters series. Cybernoid, really hard C64 game. Though, with practice, I can get quite good at it. It's unique, but it ain't great. River City Ransom. Sister series to both Renegade, or I think it's a sequel to Renegade and Super Dodgeball, and the sister series to Double Dragon. So there's Phantasy Star 2. Thank you, my hat. Gradius Rebirth. This game drove me and Phil up the wall trying to get past a certain level. Gotta be powered up and not die to get past that level. Puyo Puyo 2 for the Mega Drive. And all. Essentially, Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine from Japan. Landstalker, this is an RPG, I think. Yes, and I actually don't have a memory of it. I do remember playing it. Well, I guess I do have a recollection of playing it. But I really can't say much beyond that. And there's Phantasy Star 2. Not as competent as an RPG, like I said, as Final Fantasy. You know, for Genesis owners, if that's all there was, that's all there was. Rolling Thunder 2. Rolling Thunder 2 is interesting because it adds a very hot woman, who I guess was the woman captured in the first game. Why they would release this and not the first Rolling Thunder or the third Rolling Thunder, which I heard got low marks, I don't know anything about it, I haven't played it, but well, there you go. And Rolling Thunder is essentially James Bond anime. Black Tiger, a Capcom game. Pretty good arcade platformer. No accident they put the arcade version here. And you go around collecting things, rescuing people, and stuff like that. Kind of this weird dungeon. I'm only thinking of XX. XX. Oh, that's a shooter. Wow. Getting my game wrong. Mordine. Mordine from Namco. That's the TurboGrafx version, which is essentially almost arcade perfect. At least I think it is. And it's a cute shooter, again, another one of these funny shooters. Gotta go to the shop and buy stuff. It's my wife's game, although I've played it as well. Next up is Psychosis, another boring, mediocre, nothing wrong, nothing bad with it, TurboGrafx shooter. Riot Zone. Riot Zone it's okay, but it's a poor man's Final Fight, or poor man's Double Dragon, or poor man's Streets of Rage. I mean, I would recommend it if you like that kind of game. It is that good, but it's not that good. It's better than Mutation Nation. I'll give it that. That's a Neo Geo game. Pop. Just pop the bubbles that come up on the screen. Retro City Rampage. That's the closest you're going to getting GTA on the Wii. No joke. That is the closest you, me, everybody's going to get to having GTA. One of the funniest games, one of the best games ever made. Retro City Rampage. It's on WiiWare. I recommend it. I really do. It's a really good game. Shinobi, the arcade version. Not the crappy 8-bit version. Shinobi, the arcade version. You get a 200 life option. The game is fucking hard and it's fucking excellent. There's no other way to put that. That is a really good game. Star Force. That's a shooter. What I don't like about the shooter is when I die, it sends me all the way back to the beginning of the level. You know, if I die, just have me resume. So, Alex Kidd in Shinobi World. Weird. It has like Shinobi music and stuff. I'm Alex Kidd. I think this is the Master System. I don't know if there is a better one. Geo Poke. A shooter that tried to be different. Everyone has this one also. They have Defend Your Castle and Kiyotoke on their Wiis. I don't know what to say about that. It's weird. Gyro Star. Matt Murphy and I both have this game. We just cannot figure out. You know, it wants to be like Wipeout, but it doesn't. I just recommend Fast Racing League. MDK2. The developer actually bitched about putting this on WiiWare. Hey, dummy. No one told you to put it on WiiWare. You chose to do that. They had to cram the whole game into 40 megabytes for the WiiWare download, and they said they didn't sell 9,000. Well, maybe MDK has no more popularity? Or did you sell more on a different platform? Come on, show us the numbers. Show us why. What's the deal with MDK2? Does anyone know that MDK2 is available on WiiWare, other than maybe diehard Nintendo enthusiasts? Do I recommend this game? Yes. But, you know, the developer, I don't know what his deal was. The head of the developer, I should say, not the developer, but yeah. I think he should have just converted the game and made it a disc-based game. I don't know why he chose, or he could have chopped it up into two. That's what they did with Crystal Defenders and SquareSoft. For some reason, he went ahead and did it. It's actually a very good version of the game. Star Soldier, and I don't know if it's on here. I'm supposed to have Star Soldier R as well, but I don't see it here. Star Soldier is a pretty hard shooter from Hudson Soft. Yeah, surprising, it's not on TurboGrafx. I think Superstar Soldier is the one on TurboGrafx. It should be here too. I don't know where these games are. Just really hard shooters. Last Ninja. There is an NES version, so why the Commodore version? I never got around to buying Last Ninja 2. Weird. Space Invaders, original game. Original as a Nintendo published, a Taito developed version. It's exactly that. It's Space Invaders. It's just an irritatingly hard Space Invaders. I'd rather play Space Invaders on my Atari 2600. Or I have this PS2 version of Space Invaders, or the PlayStation version. That's like all, it's called a cute-em-up, but whatever. My aquarium. Nickel and dime you to get more fish and stuff like that. That's exactly what it is. Aquarium. That's the Master System version of Space Harrier. I bought that because it was familiar. I should have just bought the Virtual Console Arcade version. 1942. That is the arcade version of 1942. Also, tilt the screen. And stuff like that. There's all kinds of options for that. It's good. Very good game. Altered Beast, that is the arcade version. I hate to put it this way. I think Altered Beast, after eating it maybe twice, it ain't great. Blues Journey, Environmentalism meets the Neo Geo. My wife wanted that game. She bought it. It's too good. Alex Kidd. Sega's answer to Nintendo's Mario. You know, it's just a mediocre game. Weird, I don't have this. There it is. I need to wear a Superstar Soldier. That's Street Fighter II Champion Edition. That's the TurboGrafx-16 version. If you want to see how good the system actually was for its time, yeah, the sound and music and everything is, you know, low end, but it's actually on the high end for its system. And yeah, Star Soldier R. This is a weird version of the game. It's like there's a full version of the game that you can't play. It's like 2 or 5 minutes. If anyone knows if I'm wrong on this, please let me know. Space Invaders get even. This time you play as the aliens going around space invading. Destroy towns and stuff like that in order to rescue aliens. No pack of cards. It's all about penguins. You can tell there's penguins going across the icon right there. And there's like this bitchy penguin who speaks Japanese. Other than that, I never really got into the game. Nor my wife. I saw her play it. She really didn't care much for the grumpy penguin. That's the arcade version of Tecmo Bowl. I made a mistake. That's not a good version of Tecmo. It even has a weird screen. I don't know how to put it. That's just not a good version of Tecmo. Zaxxon for the arcade. I do have Zaxxon. I was wondering if I had any copies of Zaxxon other than... Well, I have it on ColecoVision. I have it on Atari. There it is. Zaxxon. 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 Zaxxon is a unique shooter. Is it a good game? Yes. Is it a hard game? Yes. It's meant to be a quarter from hell. World Heroes, the poor man's Street Fighter, the poor man's bit of Fury. World Heroes, though, people have fond memories of. Sometimes you go to an arcade and you have Street Fighter, Double Dragon, or anything else, and World Heroes would be there. People would play it. I'm very fond of the Sunsoft version of Super NES and Bad Play Control. Not as bad as the Genesis version. Oh my, they featured that for, I believe, in 10 games, 10 minutes episode. King of Fighters 94. I bought that before the Orochi collection was released. So, or King of Fighters Anthology, I think is what it's called. And, I just never liked King of Fighters 94. I don't know what it is. It's just not a good game. I don't know how else to put that. Not a good game. So I am, it looks to me, oh there it is, Shinobi 3. Shinobi 1 is an excellent game. I don't know what is Shinobi 2, by the way. And then there's Shinobi 3, an excellent game. I really recommend Shinobi 3, Shinobi 1, the Virtual Console Arcade version, and Shinobi 3. This is also available on 3DS. I do recommend this game. I believe the first Shinobi is also available on Xbox 360 and PS3. These are good, good games. Shining Force. And a little bit of strategy? Well, there you go. Shining Force. It's also it's an excellent RPG. And it's different. It relies more on strategic placement of the characters during battle, moves, and stuff like that. That's okay. It's okay. There's also Shining Force, Shining in the Darkness. It's decent. It's a JRPG, very decent, but it ain't great. That's the problem. It ain't great. Not bad. No one ever complained about buying Shining in the Darkness. And people might have fond memories of it. You know, people have fond memories of Crusader Vicente because it's just like... You notice they don't have the first Streets of Rage. That's not an accident. I do want to address this, and I'm not ragging on James Rolfe, but he did these video game memories series many, many years ago. And he did this one, Super NES versus Genesis, and he compared the wrong version to Streets of Rage, in my opinion. Now, I'm sure since then, he's probably played Streets of Rage 2 or Streets of Rage 3. I find both of these games superior to anything Final Fight has to offer. I know other people are wherever on that, but I just think that the Genesis version of Streets of Rage 2 and Streets of Rage 3 are excellent games in that genre. I also believe that Streets of Rage 2 is the peak of that genre. After that, it was all downhill. There's Street Fighter 2 Special Champion Edition, that's the Genesis version. Need I say any more? Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, that's the Ultra Games version, that was on the NES. That was available for a very, very short time, I believe, on the eShop channel. I happened to get it, and then I gave away the original cartridge to my nephew. He was a big Turtles fan. The game is crap. I don't have any other way to put it. I actually think that Castlevania Symphony of the Night is a remake of this Turtles game. I don't know if I've said that before, but I'm saying it now. If I had said it before, I'm saying it again. The game's crap, in my opinion. It's hard. It's too hard. The controls aren't good or anything. Mike Matei, who played the game on a live stream, he says it's not a bad game. I gotta disagree, Mr. Matei. I really do think that this is what it is. It's a bad game. It's a poorly made game. There's no other way around. The only reason it's fondly remembered is it is a Turtles game. And Wonder Boy, or should I say Adventure Island, that baffled me when I bought Wonder Boy. Where is Adventure Island? I thought I bought Adventure Island and Wonder Boy both on Virtual Console. Maybe it's just Wonder Boy, and I have Adventure Island maybe on the NES itself. But whatever it was, it confused me. They're the exact same game in my opinion. I haven't played through either. Adventure Island is just not any good, and Wonder Boy is just as bad. Wonder Boy would go on to have his own series, as would Master Higgins and Adventure Island. So it's weird that there's actually two game series with the exact same game for their first game. Virtua Fighter 2 for the Genesis. It plays like Virtua Fighter, so that's good. And, it plays, okay. Oh, and that's where it ends. Now, that's Super Street Fighter 2, the new challenger, that's the Genesis version. It's one of the first games I've seen that if the Wii is set up to widescreen, it will pillbox it, which means that it makes a square fit, but it's the wrong resolution. It's not stretched to a 4x3 screen. It's something else. I think it's the literal Genesis resolution. That's very bad. The good part was for a while that was available to play online, so we do that a lot. So we played that a lot online back when it was allowed to be online. You probably played me if you were. Mercs, the actual sequel to Commando. And that's all I can say about it, other than that's a good version of Mercs. I really enjoy this version, I have to say, when I think of Mercs, I think of the Genesis version of the game. I like it that much. Adventures of Lolo 2. Bought that for my wife. I played it a few times after I beat the original Adventures of Lolo. And I guess she doesn't like it. I don't know, I thought she liked two characters. There it is, Super Star Soldier. As for the Turbo Graphics, this is a good one, but it's hard. It's fucking hard. It's really hard. But at least I can play the game, like Star Soldier R. Vigilante. I don't know. How do you want to put Vigilante? You're gonna ask. There's Kung Fu 2, which I don't know if it ever came out in America. Though I have seen advertisements, and I have actually held the cartridge in my hand at a convention. So that it may not have been finalized. I do believe it came out in Japan, and then this is Vigilante, which plays exactly like Kung Fu. After beating it once, it's not anything to come back to. Kung Fu, I don't know, Kung Fu Master? What I should call it. That's a new game. Now, next up is, Through Space. Tetris meets Blockout. That's about the only way to describe it. My wife likes the game, I don't. And the legendary Faxanadu. Why I say legendary? Check out Myst Town. Remember, this was made on an NES. Also, by Hudson Soft and Falcom. It's a really good action RPG, similar more to Zelda 2. Captain N did an episode on it. It's a saying that was a good thing, but they did do an episode on it. And I recommend if you want to, buy it on the Wii Shop channel, Max Anity. Once you get into the game, you can't put it down. Just Mistown, the World Tree. You can even gyp the king. I did that without even remembering how to do the trick properly. It's an excellent game, Max Anity. And with that, we're moving over to the Wii U side. Right, the Wii U side of things. Okay, I'm back. I don't know what happened over there. Now, you can see the game I'm playing currently is Warriors Orochi 3 Hyper. I don't know what the NA stands for, but maybe not applicable. But anyways, there's a game that more people should have bought on the Wii U than actually sold. But let's go to the downloadable game, or games I have downloaded. Okay, the first thing is this screen doesn't count, although there are weird accessories like this, or like this, which I've used a few times. Yeah, there's those, but let's go over here to the Wii Fit You Quick Check. I don't know. The Wii Fit You sucks, and I think Nintendo should just get out of the exercise business. There's Wii Sports Club. I still haven't downloaded everything for that. And then, over here... Oops, that was too far down. Spiky Walls. That's right, Spiky Walls. Flappy Birds. That's a good game. If you like Flappy Bird, you'll like Spiky Walls. Next is the Wonderful 101. Really, I couldn't get into the game, and I don't blame consumers for just not even trying. But then, that's a problem we have right now in gaming, is unless it's Call of Duty and Madden and, you know, whatever, things aren't selling. There seems to be no way to get people to buy things anymore. The reason for that is the magazines have disappeared. Believe me, the only reason why Street Fighter 2 and anime is still in America is because of 1990s EGM. They were promoting it at every corner. They became the official spokesperson of video games. Or maybe non-official, but whatever they said went within that culture, and the other magazines all became like EGM. Now we have I've Got to Run. It's a good arcade-style game. That one was nearly free, I believe, or it might have been free. Unfortunately, I don't really care much for the fake charity the money was given to. Alright, let's see, Pikmin 3, that's my wife's game. I don't play it, although the graphics are perfectly on par with, heck, even a PS4 or an Xbox One, or some later model graphic cards. Toss and Go, wow. Don't remember this game. Fist of the North Star, Ken's Rage 2. I did a video recently of me playing it. There you go. It uses the Dynasty Warriors engine, or, well, play mechanics, I should say, because an engine is an actual mechanical device that pumps out a result from fuel. So this is Ken's Rage 2. It's one of the better games on the Wii U, but it's not cheap. And it's download only, so is a certain One Piece game. 99 Moves. It has 99 moves. That's all there is to it, just a little indie game there. Injustice, Gods Among Us. I need to explain, and I probably explained it before, I'll explain it again. Mortal Kombat, after DC versus Mortal Kombat, split into two series. Well, not split into two series. DC versus Mortal Kombat ended Mortal Kombat, and that series went into Injustice, now getting a sequel in Injustice 2. I have quite a few things downloaded here. It's a very good fighting game. Definitely worth the purchase price. Actually, I think this one was free for some reason. Yeah, I remember that. For some reason, I had given a download code or something for this, so when I had downloaded it. I can't, as far as Mortal Kombat goes, the one with Freddy Krueger, and then the one after that, Mortal Kombat X or XL, that's a different Mortal Kombat series. It's not a sequel to the original Mortal Kombat series that started off in 1982. Super Destronaut is exactly that. It's Space Invaders, really. There's a few different tweaks and stuff. Is it worth it? Well, see, I like Space Invaders stuff, so to me it is, but I don't think for most people it is. Lego Batman 2. Lego Batman 2, I just can't get into this game. It's humorous and it plays well and everything, but for some reason, this Lego game, I just can't get into. Shut the box, self-explanatory, shut the box. Wheel of Fortune, I've been meaning to buy Jeopardy for years now. I might just buy the disc version since that seems to be cheap. Wheel of Fortune. And that's exactly what it is. This is the game show Wheel of Fortune. This is for my wife. Abyss. Not really a good game. My idea is to go guide that thing without touching the walls. Yeah, enjoy. Watch Dogs. Is Watch Dogs an offshoot of the Driver series? I think it is. But don't quote me on that. This is a good game. Allegedly, the Wii U can't do it, but it does just fine. I don't know if there was any downloadable content that could come to the Wii U version, but I definitely enjoyed Watch Dogs. And I haven't played it in about 2 or 3 years. 2 years, I think. I'm not sure. 2 years, yeah. Edge. Edge is good. I have this also on my 3DS. That's how good it is. But no, I will not be rebuying it for my PS4 or anything like that. Not that. It's just a simple little game about, it kind of reminds me of Intelligent Cube. That's on PlayStation. Darksiders 2, played through it once, never came back. Darksiders, the series, I'll buy the War Mastered Edition, but they're play once, don't play again. Block Drop X Twisted Fusion. I don't remember this, but I remember enjoying it. Marvel Avengers Battle for Earth. Not a great Marvel game. Not really. Spin the Bottle. Bumpy's Party. Nobody wants to. This is a two-player or more only game. And nobody. I mean, nobody will play it. Not even my wife. Bayonetta, which came with Bayonetta 2. Leave it at that. Speaking of babes, Mighty Switch Force. This is Hyperdrive Edition. I still haven't, other than being on the Wii U, I haven't found a difference from this in the 3DS version that I have. Both Bayonetta and Mighty Switch Force are excellent games. So is Bayonetta 2, and so is Mighty Switch Force 2. And that's why they're all grouped down here together. These four games are excellent. I definitely recommend them. I've enjoyed this game. This is Arkham Origins Black Gate, Deluxe Edition. That's about all I can say about it, other than I enjoyed it. Geome, don't remember it. Minecraft, do I really have to go into Minecraft? This should be obvious. Chubbins, I remember, yeah, this game, it lacks polish, but it's playable. Resident Evil Revelation. I think that was free. That's why I have it here instead of on disc. And it's an okay game, but Resident Evil's been blast for. The Letter. I don't remember anything about it. This is Fatal Frame, obviously. Made in the Black Water. Haven't gotten into it yet. Why is it here? I didn't buy it. This is actually free. Rush. Don't remember it. Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. Can't get into it. There's supposed to be all this high praise for Monster Hunter and everything on both Wii and 3DS and the Wii U. And I just found the games bleh. Poker Dice Solitaire Future. I don't know how you can make such a bad game. Rayman Legends. I did enjoy this. I haven't played it recently. Rayman just doesn't hold the panache it did 20 years ago. This is Block Drop U. The Pinball Arcade. I've bought a few machines. You can download the Pinball Arcade free and get one table for free. But they're, then buy the season packs or whatever. I just went ahead and bought the PS4 disc version. I got a lot of the tables I was looking for. And I didn't pay that much for it. You Wordsmith. My wife likes this, I don't, and she hasn't played it in 2 years. Donkey Kong Country, Tropical Freeze. Not a bad game if you're a Donkey Kong Country Returns fanatic. Not too great overall, though, especially compared to the three originals. Ice Cream Surfer, that's a shoot 'em up, and that's where it ends. NES Remix. And NES Remix 2. Now, I think today these are combined into one download or disc. I bought Matt Murphy one for Christmas a few years ago. And, again, not ragging on anyone, but James and Mike totally bonered themselves by... I'd have to say, it's the, when they played NES Remix, I don't know which version they played, but by playing it, they really showed how ignorant they were about a lot of the games that they're supposed to be knowledgeable on. And, you know, that's kind of what's turned me off from watching Cinemassacre. I mean, he has good movie reviews, good funny videos, like he did this fake black and white trailer about these humping aliens or whatever. I mean, that's all fine and dandy, but, you know, to call himself the nerd and then he has, you know, this collection of games and video game stuff and then not have knowledge on how to play NES Remix, I'm not kidding. That's kind of bad. Now, for me, I had no problem with any of this stuff. And I even made footage of it, and I wasn't able to use it because when I put it up, it got flagged for copyright. Amiibo Tap. What this game is, it's free, and just take an Amiibo, tap it, play a level or two for a few minutes. Midnight. Stupid game. That's all I can say about it. DuckTales Remastered. I wish I had this on disc, but I have it here, and that's Shantae meets DuckTales. It's a good game. We have here Asteroid Quarry, don't remember it. See, a lot of these indie games, they come in, you pay a buck or two, maybe up to $10 maximum, and they're forgettable. But not forgettable, the ones that have polish and try to do something. Steam World Dig has to be one of the best games ever made, and I liked it so much I wanted more save slots that I decided to buy the Wii U, and now I have the PS4 and the PS Vita. Stoneshire. Imagine a proof of concept demo for saying the Wii U can do Minecraft. That's it right there. Again, one of the best games ever made, Angry Video Game Nerd Adventures. So I find it ironic that it's done in the style of these games. And that's NES Remix 1 and 2, 8-bit legacy stuff. And you know, it has a lot of whatever, but yet he was just not knowledgeable on how to play the NES Remix. He has tackled this game in an episode of his, so I think he can beat it. And that's being the nerd himself, James Rolfe. The Legend of Zelda, The Wind Waker HD. Now this, I have to, I do have the original GameCube disc. So what's the deal with me having it here? Well, the deal with me having it here is, at the time, I didn't have an old Wii hooked up to play GameCube in HDMI. So this was the only way to do it. And it's also a good thing they did release this, and it's available for download, so people don't have to pay those douchebag collectors a ton of money for it. Zen Pinball 2, I bought a few tables here. I have most of the tables on the Xbox 360 version, and they have a lot of tables not here, or divided up when we get to that. And that's a shame. I don't know, the game isn't as fun here. The 360 version is where it's at. Hyrule Warriors. Enough said. Star Wars Pinball. So instead of putting the tables in here, they put the tables over here, and I can buy more than just the tables I have bought. Again, I have these tables already on the 360 version, so I don't know. I don't know what the deal was, why we ended up buying like this, and the Pinball Arcade. It's like repeating stuff. I do have the Pinball Arcade on the 360 also. This one, take an Amiibo and play a Mario vs. Donkey Kong kind of thing. Without Amiibo, can't play it. Child of Light was supposed to be a good game and everything. I played it once and never came back. Lost Reavers was another free-to-play. Pure Solar and the Great Architects. That has to be one of the better RPGs out there in the last 20 years. Done in the 16-bit style on purpose. Vampire Mike at Sega CD Universe actually liked it. They do recommend this game. Pac-Man and the Ghostly Adventures. What a disappointment. Not as disappointing as Gaia Breaker. This shooter damns a person to one side of the screen, and that's it. Now, this was supposed to lead to more arcade games coming out. It's the Dungeon Dragon Chronicles of Mystara. I don't even know if that's a real word. Probably not, because it's Dungeon Dragon, but it's Capcom's Dungeon Dragon. And not really too good, in my opinion. This is Guiana Sister's Twisted Dreams. It's the same version I also have on 360. But I wanted it here. Can't say why again. A lot of it might have to do with these might have been bought at a time when the 360 was in the bedroom. It came out physically as a director's cut, so I consider that actually a different game, though it is the same game from what I can tell. Here it is, Fast Racing Neo. This is the approved version. Very good racing game. Not an F-Zero fix, a Wipeout fix, if you like Wipeout, or Extreme G, even though these are hover cars. Another World Out of This World. I put both titles there. Recently played by James and Mike. And as of this recording. I just can't get into this game. And it seems, not that it seems dated or anything. I used to be a big Out of This World flashback and Heart of the Alien fan. But what happened, well, it's all the conventions that it's built up to no longer groundbreaking. Maybe I have more fun with it on Super NES. Freedom Planet. What happened here? The levels are too long. I like the whole idea that it wants to be Sonic. But man, oh man, are the levels too long. I cannot tolerate that. I should be done with the level in 2 to 3 minutes. Not. I think I was going on to 15 minutes or something. But just too long. Just too damn long, you know. For the person who makes Freedom Planet, listen to me. Get it down, get it fast, get it going for the sequel. This is just, the levels are just too long. Nano Assault Neo. I remember enjoying this for about 10 minutes and then getting bored. Another free-to-play. I haven't bought a thing for it. Puddle. I found out this came out on other game systems. Not very good. Not very bad, just kind of in the middle. Occupies you when it's your second. This was actually my second Wii U game when we got the Wii U. This was it, Puddle. Cloudberry Kingdom. Again, another game with high hopes. Played it. Never came back for it. I got pretty far, but I didn't beat it. That was all in one sitting. Tank, Tank, Tank. And it has DL in parentheses. There's also Tank, 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 the disc version. Either way, it's going to set you back $40. TNT Racers. Fun little RC Pro-Am type racers. Bit Trip presents Runner 2, Future Legend of Rhythm Julian, starring the voice of Super Mario. He says his name is Martinet, I guess. Looks like Martinet. My name isn't... People get my name wrong all the time. This game was really good, a lot of fun. Just run with a little bit of strategy. Kung Fu Rabbit. This is a good platformer and a little bit of strategy. Dr. Luigi. Now, I just play the Dr. Mario mode. The Dr. Luigi mode has two vitamins together to make an L shape. If you are a subscriber to my channel, you should be familiar with all the Smash Brothers for Wii U uploads I have. Here's the $120 version of Super Mario Maker. Why do I call it that? Because I originally bought the game on disc, just playing, using the hell out of it. Then I gave that to Phil Barnes, and I downloaded it again. But in a way, it was a Christmas or a birthday gift. But he doesn't play it anymore, and neither do I. After you've done it, what's there to do with it? Super Mario 3D World. I did make a video of me beating it. It was flagged for copyright. Fuck you, Nintendo. And, well, there it is. And I would love to do video of this, me playing the whole thing, every level through as Rosalina. But no, I know, I can't do it. I can't do it without violating the TGN contract about copyrighted claims, and I can't do it without, well, again, getting flagged. If I went to a different account, I wouldn't be here. Mario Kart 8, again, you should be familiar. I got hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of highlights from this game, some with the music, some without. Game and Wario, what a disappointment. But maybe Wario's been headed that way for a while. It was free. It was okay. Tokitori and Tokitori 2 Plus, these are excellent, just excellent games. I have the Game Boy Original. I put it here because, well, it doesn't look like I'm going to be playing Game Boy anytime soon on my TV anymore. And I've enjoyed both these games. And show a little love. Get them. They're not that expensive. Journey of a Special Average Balloon. I haven't played it since the day I bought it. This is the first Earthbound game, called Earthbound the Beginnings. It wasn't the first on Virtual Console, but it was the first here. It's been nice and translated, and it is still just as hilarious and groovy as Earthbound. Buy Earthbound here, folks. If you have a Wii U, or you can obtain a Wii U, get it here. Do not buy the original Super NES cartridge, because for some reason, everyone likes to butt-fuck Earthbound as if it's the best game that ever came out. And, you know, it's a good game, it's a fun game, but it ain't what they say it is. And believe it or not, a lot of people today would not be entertained by either Earthbound game. I hate to say that, but it's the truth. And I'm here to tell you the truth. Excitebike. Versus Excitebike. That's more or less the Japanese version. Sin and Punishment for Nintendo 64. You know, I played this for a good many hours, and I just can't get into it. But I can get into Breath of Fire and Breath of Fire 2. I love these two games. I wish they released more. I think Breath of Fire 3 and 4 on PlayStation. These are from Capcom, even though I think one was translated by Square, the other was released by Capcom. I just love it. I love both of these. They're much better RPGs than Earthbound. But, again, it's people's taste, and, you know, I might be praising these high up to heaven. And the same thing with Earthbound, though. There's someone butt-fucking me saying that they're worth more than they are. They're not. They're pretty common, especially the first one. They're pretty common games. Golden Sun. Bought it here. Tried to get into it. Did not. Advance Wars. Same thing. Bought it. Tried to get into it. Could not. New Horizons and Romance of the Three Kingdoms 4. These are strategic RPGs from Koei, and I really did enjoy these games. But, you know, at the same time, I'm not really any good at these games anymore. I've just gotten older. This is Pokemon Pinball Ruby and Sapphire, not the Pokemon Pinball that I would recommend. Kelowna, overrated. It's okay. This is a good pinball game, though. Say that. Legend of Mystical Ninja. Now, this is truly one of the funniest games ever. Oh, that's weird. Look, I got Lode Runner here, and I have it on the Wii side. Well, I already addressed Lode Runner. Balloon Fight. Definitely, I enjoy Balloon Fight. Let's just joust. It is. Pilot Wings. I used to really be into this game, so I bought it with the hope I could get into it again, and I can't. So, you know, what I was into at one time, I'm not decades later. Still play Dig Dug. Yeah, it's probably a monthly thing. 1080 Snowboarding. I can address a whole lot of personal things about this, but this is a... It's so dated now. It just really is. Vegas Stakes. I bought that with the impression my wife would enjoy it, but she refuses to touch it. I've played it a few times. Adventure Island with Master Higgins, or should I call it Sega's Wonder Boy? Brain Age. I have the original DS cartridges, and I have one Brain Age Express. I really don't
why bother? Yes, it's good for the brain, but it's nagware. It's the worst case of nagware. Duck Hunt. This replaces my original cartridge. Big Brain Academy. What a piece of crap. Mr. Driller 2. Well, that's exactly what it is. Mr. Driller, but 2. Not bad, not good. It's Mr. Driller. ZVS. This is the NES version. I have this actually replaces my 7800 cartridge. Ninja Gaiden 1, 2, and 3. Do I have to address anything? I mean, this is a legendary trilogy of Nintendo hard. Still no regular Contra here, and the PS4 has a crappy arcade version. Here's Super C, not a crappy version. But with only 10 lives, gotta be a little bit more judicious in decisions being made. The excellent Contra 3, the Alien Wars, and the not-so-excellent Alien Wars EX. And there's also the Alien Wars on Game Boy. By Factor 5, of all people. This is not a bad game, though. This is a good Contra game. This is better. And if I told you, get this or Contra Rebirth. Punch-Out, featuring Mr. Dream, not Mike Tyson, but I have the cartridge is Mike Tyson. So this replaces that cartridge. Super Punch-Out. My cartridge is missing, so that replaces that. F-Zero. F-Zero Maximum Velocity. F-Zero GP Legend. Hey, you like F-Zero? There you go. There's three F-Zeros right here. And I believe F-Zero X is also available. No, it's not here. I played the hell out of F-Zero and F-Zero X. These two, not so much, because I was in my 20s. Here's Gradius. I also have the other version of Gradius, but here's Gradius. The TurboGrafx version, I mean. Life Force, which I always thought was a sequel to Gradius. There it is. Axlay, or Axel A, Axel I, or whatever. It says Axlay, so I don't know. One of the better shooters. Got a unique perspective. Gradius, Life Force, and Axlay are like legendary shooters. But so legendary, no one remembers them. Renegade! This is a strange version of Renegade. I saw both Gaming History Source and Battle of the Ports. RetroCore's Battle of the Ports and Gaming History Source's Let's Compare videos on Renegade. I don't think there's ever been an arcade-perfect version of Renegade on a home system. I remember a lot of people liked Renegade in the arcade. I've only seen it in the arcade once. And the one time I did, the machine was broken. It was just frozen up. Super Dodgeball. I just bought the PS4 version. That was a mistake. Now, see, I was hoping that I'd have the fun of this game on that game. I don't. This is probably one of the best games ever made. It was actually released by CGS ImageSoft, who's today a company that makes PlayStation, Sony Electronic Publishing. Sony Computer. Well, it's actually Sony Electronic Publishing, and then they do business as Sony Computer Entertainment. So forth and so on. They have corporations, LLCs, and limiteds. This is a really good game. I recommend it. River City Ransom, not so much. There's man's ass and it'll eat a lot, whatever. Double Dragon on the NES. For a long, long time, I had absolute hatred toward this game because I wanted the arcade version. I wanted the Master System version or the 7800 version, which played like the arcade, not the 2600 version. I even had the computer version that, you know, I preferred, and the Genesis version, which was supposed to be arcade perfect. According to RetroCore, it is. In fact, to him, it's better than the arcade, but now that I'm in my 30s, I was 8 years old when this came out. I'm 37 now, and I have to say, in the last 5 years, I've grown to love this version more than any because of its familiarity. I own the original cartridge. I played the hell out of the original cartridge. I have this also on my 3DS. Double Dragon 2, The Revenge. This game is beautiful. It's hard, but it's beautiful. But Most of us, with me and my friends included, we never made it past the jumping platform mission 6. This game is beautiful. I have it also on my 3DS, and I have it also on my Famicom Mini. Double Dragon 3, The Sacred Stones. Fuck it. It is terrible. Adventures of Lolo. I'll tell you what's terrible about this. And I'm going to do a drive-by review. But you know what's terrible about that? You only get one life. If they had just resolved that instead of going this other route, this would be a legendary game. Because the control is perfect. The music is perfect. The graphics are perfect. Except Billy and Jimmy look like they're trying to hold in a shit with their stances. But other than that, it is perfect except for the one life thing. And what's strange is Nintendo Power didn't even gave it a mention, and that was it. There's no review of this by Nintendo Power. Unlike Double Dragon and Double Dragon 2. And almost everyone I know has this game who were like there's two types of NES owners. I was the type who had all the badass games. I had Double Dragon and Double Dragon 2. Kirby's Adventure, Life Force, Gradius. Super Dodgeball, you know, Ninja Gaiden 1, 2, and 3. Then there was the second tier owners. They would have, like, The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, Bugs Bunny's Birthday Blowout, Double Dragon 3, a couple of Tengen games or Color Dream games. Anyways, Adventures of Lolo, combined strategy with action. Bomberman meets Kirby. Speaking of that, Kirby! This is the excellent Kirby's Adventure. And I have to say, Kirby has... I'll talk about it in a minute. Kirby Superstar, boring to me. I didn't enjoy it. Kirby's Dream Course, meh. Kirby and the Amazing Mirror, I like. Now I'm going to talk about this. Kirby 64, I really liked. I feel that Kirby's Adventure and Kirby 64 and Kirby's Dream Land 3 are like the best Kirby's. I haven't played any recent Kirby's though. Metroid I ended up buying on a whim, just because I wanted to play Metroid again, and my original cartridge is long gone. Apparently I did replace it. I think the cartridge was stolen from me. That would be fair. I think that would be more than fair. And Super Metroid, just a beautiful game. There's no other way to put that. Super Metroid is like one of the most perfect games ever made. With Metroid, I just love wandering around. Not necessarily making progress. I'll put in my code from 30 years ago. Wow, has it been that long? I'll put in my code from like 30 years ago for Metroid and just goof around like that. Metroid Fusion, I did enjoy it, but it ain't great. I'm glad it's like regular Metroid, like Super Metroid is. But it's good for what it was. It was meant to give people a reason to buy the Game Boy Advance. Here's Pac-Man. Here's the awful version of Pac-Land. I don't know why they didn't go with the TurboGrafx version. There's even a version of this on Atari Lynx. It plays like Pac-Land. It is Pac-Land. Make no doubt about it. It's just not a good version. And this was their answer. This Pac-Man, Pac-Land, Pac-Man Collection, and Namco Museum was Namco's answer for not giving us Pac-Man Museum on Wii U. Pac-Man Collection has a pretty good version of Pac-Mania, and Pac-Man Arranged, and one other game I can't remember, but not Pac-Land. This has Ms. Pac-Man, Pole Position, and a few other things. These are decent for what they are. There are emulators running on an emulator. Go figure. Do I really have to talk about this? No, I don't. Or this one. Or that one. Or that one. Or this one. What I like about this, it shows Link's cap out talks and stuff like that. I mean, these Zelda games are all excellent. All five that I have here, and there's more. There's more. I want to download more. I can't get enough Zelda. Though I do bash Zelda, because it is overrated. Zelda is overrated. Make no mistake about that. a lot of walking. Maddox pointed that, just a lot of walking, especially in the versions that are 3D like that. But they're excellent games because people put their soul into Zelda. None of these Zelda games are half-assed. They say the closest Zelda game that's half-assed, and not counting the CDI trilogy, would be Link's Crossbow Training. Castlevania. Yes, Castlevania. And Castlevania 2. Castlevania 2 is not really a bad game. It's just way, way different. Castlevania 3 is... It goes back to its roots. It's a prequel to Castlevania. Just a lot of fond memories of this one. I noticed that people who have 2 never bought 3. People who have 3 never bought 2. But then there's me who have 1. I have a lot of fond memories of Simon's Quest, Dracula's Curse. Now, you're thinking, a person's only alive at anywhere from 600,000 to 1 million hours. And in my childhood, you know, we can go ahead and do the calculation, but from the summer of 88 and up, I don't know how, but I was able to play a lot of these games and get very, very far on. Maybe I was an idiot savant. I know I'm an idiot. Super Castlevania 4, another one I spent eons playing. I can't get enough of this game to this day. And I've beaten it every way, every which way. I did make footage of me before. I do have to continue. I'm not saying I'm an expert or anything, but I put the game on hard. I made footage of it, of me playing, and I wasn't able to use it. Got flagged for copyright. Dracula X. This is a poo-poo version. it's not really bad if I didn't know about Rondo of Blood, but I have Rondo of Blood imported, and I have it on the Wii side. Castlevania, Circle of the Moon, Symphony of the Night for your Game Boy. I'm just so disconnected with the characters from this that I really, while I did play through it, I never really enjoyed it. Same goes for Harmony of Dissonance and Aria Sarv. Now, when I say I played through it, I didn't mean I played it through here. These I'm like stuck on, or I've just forgotten about. I always play Castlevania in October, same with Ghosts and Goblins, but lately I've been going outside of that. I mean, there's no real reason I should be playing on the month of Halloween, but whatever. And I just really never really got into these, but the DS versions are a different story. Mighty Final Fight, one of the best fighting games ever made. And I really recommend this game to people. You'll like it. You'll get tired of the level up system. And that's the problem. Final Fight 1 fixes a lot of problems that a fight had, but has a lot of other problems all its own. Both of these two are, yeah, they're good games. But this is more for fondness. I really do prefer Streets of Rage over Final Fight. Final Fight 2 and 3, now, these really give Streets of Rage a run for their money. Not as good, this one is better than Streets of Rage 2, and better, way better than Streets of Rage 3. This one is right under Streets of Rage 2, but it fixes a lot of problems from these two. Yeah. Yep. Obviously. Do I have anything against... Well, a lot of people consider this, Street Fighter 2 Turbo Hyper Fighter, the finest fighting game ever made. The controls, this is just perfect. And the music is great. But the voices are better in this, and, you know, we all started here. I like these because they saved my high school. There's that. I don't know. It's a hit and miss. I guess it was good at the time to have Street Fighter Portable. Street Fighter 2 Portable, I should say. But me and my street fighting buddies, we can never get into it, even playing against each other. Now this we got into, but it has access time, which is something they could have fixed in the code. But yes, it has access time. Round 1, fight! And then you wait 5 seconds. Time. 5 seconds. And now that I have Mega Man Legacy, but Mega Man Legacy only goes up to 6. Mega Man
See, at the time I bought these, I wanted all the Mega Man games that were available. And then 7X, X2, and X3. And Mega Man Legacy on PS4 only goes up to 6. And obviously, there's Mega Man 7, Mega Man X, X2, and X3. And I have these also to replace cartridges. I never had Mega Man 7. I never saw it sold, to be honest. Never, ever saw it sold in Las Vegas. Mega Man Zero, it's a good continuation of X, I guess. I don't know. I don't know where it fits in the timeline. And these, didn't enjoy these at all. I bought both of them on the same day. I never played them before, and I thought, what the hell. This is my 3DS version of Donkey Kong has the high level. This one does not. Although I'm more familiar with this version. Donkey Kong Jr. This is a shooter, Donkey Kong 3. And this is the game I wouldn't wish on my worst enemy. This and Math Grand Prix on the 2600. I love Donkey Kong Country 1, 2, and 3. These are also like some of the most perfect games ever made. One of the most perfect games ever made is also Donkey Kong 64. Which I believe is a sequel to this one right here. And these are also available in a different way. Donkey Kong Land 1, 2, and 3, 3DS. So, here's the original Mario Brothers, though I personally prefer the original 2600 version. Wrecking Crew. Why is Wrecking Crew? Well, Wrecking Crew was the second Super Mario Brothers. Or Mario Brothers. It's brother. That's that abbreviation. Allegedly Wario's in this, but he wasn't called Wario at the time. But yeah, there it is. Super Mario Brothers. Super Mario Brothers, what they call the Lost Love. Real Mario 2. I also have the Mario All-Stars disc. Curious about that. Mario Brothers 2.
Yeah.
There you go. I hate this game. Super Mario Advance. I like it in Super Mario Advance, but I hate I got this for Christmas when I was a, yeah, I know, first world problem, bratty kid. He hates Super Mario Bros. 2. I do. I do have fond memories. I'm an expert at this game. I beat it every time I play. Fast. But I hate it. I just hate this game. I don't know why I hate it so much, but I do. I think it has to do with that kind of ending is all a dream. Mario 3, enough said. This, I wish I could use the e-reader here, because I got a bunch of Mario 3 e-reader cards. What is this? Do I need more save slots? I think I just need more save slots, even though my saves all go to the same point. No, that's Mario World for you. Obviously, I have Mario 64. New Super Mario Brothers, the game that lags. I've actually knocked down my Wii U to be AV connection. The only place it doesn't lag is on the Wii U gamepad, the tablet. Everywhere else I've played this, it lags. I even called Nintendo on it, and they called me crazy. But it lags. It has a real bad lag here. It's the only game I have that lags on the TV I'm on right now. Paper Mario, talk about comedy. A lot of kids still like this game, even though it's almost 20 years old. I remember it came out the same year as the GameCube. I have a commercial for it somewhere. Mario and Luigi, Superstar Saga, Mario and Luigi, Partners in Time. These are sequels to Super Mario RPG. So is Paper Mario, kind of why the three are here. But these are not the same series. There's Super Mario RPG, and then it goes into the Paper Mario series. And then there's also the Mario and Luigi series. Dr. Mario really didn't need that other than I just missed the old bit of Dr. Mario. And it's semi-sequel Yoshi, which is not really the world's best puzzle. If it wasn't called Yoshi, no one would play it. Yoshi's Island? Why is this here and not the Super NES version? What do you notice about Super NES emulation on the Wii and Wii U? No Super FX chip. So, there you go. it was easier for them to do this. I would prefer if they had the Super NES version. Well, which is weird because I say that, but Street Fighter Alpha 2 is on Virtual Console. Yoshi's Story is a sequel to Yoshi's Island on the N64. That game, it's a bestseller. People have fond memories of it. People like my wife love it. My goddaughter loves it. But it did chase people away from the N64. That's the truth. Yoshi's Island DS. And that's all I can say about that. It's Yoshi's Island on the DS. I bought this because I couldn't find the original cartridge anymore. Yoshi's Touch and Go. Piece of crap. I mean, it would be a piece of crap on the original DS, let alone here. Wario's Woods. I don't know why they did this version and not the Super NES version. This was the last official Nintendo game. NES game, I should say, for the NES. Redundant, sorry. It has an ESRB rating of KA. It's the only NES game, I believe, that has an ESRB rating during the original NES release. Wario Land 4 is a really good Game Boy Advance game. I really enjoy it. Wario Land 3 was really good. This is, like, even better. I mean, this fixes all the problems of Wario Land 1, 2, and 3. And the Wario games are actually the Super Mario Land series. Until recently, when the Super Mario 3D Land came out. I really like the GameCube version. I bought this thinking I would have fun with it. I haven't. Actually, I didn't buy this. It's free. This is just nostalgia. That's all it's for, nostalgia. I do like Mario Kart 8. This replaces the cartridge. I actually lost the cartridge in the bedroom. Don't know where it is. I searched everywhere. I'm like, well, I guess it's not that big of a deal. So I went ahead and downloaded it. This, I just wanted to play it on my TV. I love this golf game. I used to get hole-in-one. No shit. I used to get hole-in-one on this game. I was that damn good. NES Open Tournament Golf. Allegedly the first game of Peach. Daisy. Or first home game of Daisy. Yeah. First game of Daisy was obviously Super Mario. But here, there's two Princess Peaches as caddies for Mario. Is it the sequel to this? Kinda. The prequel to this? Kinda. This plays like Hot Shots Golf. No, I'm not shitting you. It plays exactly like Hot Shots Golf. So I actually like this because I like Hot Shots Golf on the PlayStation. I enjoyed this one. I don't know. It's a good pinball game, except I get, like Sonic Spinball, I get stuck in circles. I've only played this once, and I remember like this. I don't remember enjoying it. Because it's only one player here. Didn't like this game. Didn't like it at all. Mario Tennis powered me. This is a little weird. I bought this because I didn't have Super Mario Galaxy 2. And then my mom gave me the disc. I guess she was playing it on her Wii or something like that. So then I'm just like, oh great, just bought it for $20. I like this. It replaces my GameCube game and the last one in the trilogy. I'm going to be buying Other M soon. This is a really fun and funny game. Comedy game, Punch-Out, obviously. This is where Punch-Out got back to its roots, because there's also Ready to Rumble Revolution out on the Wii, and it can't even touch Punch-Out. I have no opinion of the Fight Nights on the GameCube, and I don't think there's any Fight Nights on the Wii. Pandora's Tower is an RPG I really wanted to get into, and I just can't. I played it for a good number of hours, and I just kept losing interest. And we're almost at the end of this. Pharaoh's Riches. Now, right now, this and this one, I think this one, are at $20. I don't know why, but they are. I paid not $20 for these. I think maybe $3 or $5. They're slot machines. That's where it ends. And they're not worth the money. They're not worth $20, that's for sure. Hockey and Rocky with Becky is a really good shooter. I wish the other Hockey and Rocky were released for the Super NES here. RetroCore, he talks about him. Anyway, Hockey and Rocky with Becky. Really good game. Really recommend it. Final Fantasy Tactics Advance. This I bought for this YouTube channel. I just haven't gotten around to playing it yet, and I don't want to get around to playing it until I'm ready. Crazy Racer is actually, in my opinion, a little bit better than Mario's Kart Super Circuit. Explodey Bomb. I played it. I remember enjoying it. I don't remember much about it. Oh, this is a love letter to Metroid. This game is so good. This is one of the best games of all time as well. Like Peer Solar and SteamWorld Dig and Retro City Rampage. These are all indies. This might get a physical release soon. I cannot. Axiom Verge. Buy it. Buy it on whatever game system you can. Just buy it. It is so fucking good. Slots. The first Skunk Bundle was free. This is recent, by the way, a few months ago. Free, not any good. I don't even remember what's on it. Free to play. I know there's still the gift box around it. I haven't played it yet. I bought this because I had a hankering for R-Type. Really bad. And, there you go. I'm surprised I don't own the first Star... I own the first Star Tropics. Yes, I do. But on cartridge, I own Zoda's Revenge. I don't know why I have only Zoda's Revenge. Because I refuse to play Zoda's Revenge again until I play the first Star Tropics. Star Tropics and Star Tropics 2 are like Earthbound, okay? They're not as popular or anything like that, but they're good RPGs. Action RPGs, but they're not great. That's what I'm trying to say about Earthbound. And if someone's trying to butt-fuck you over the price of Star Tropics 2, tell them to shove it up their own ass, because Star Tropics is available here on Virtual Console, so is the Earthbound. In fact, what I would recommend is if someone has a Wii U, buy these. You know, if you're not buying it for any other reason, buy these. Have your own personal Nintendo Classic machine. Here's a Super Mario RPG, obviously. Obviously, and one of the best games ever made. It's true. Not one of the best games ever made. No, big improvement over the original Adventure Island. Okay, so here's Bonk's Adventure. This is the first one. My wife enjoys me playing this, though I don't actually enjoy it at all. Mario Party 2. This has Toad humping a boat in. I'm not joking. Why they didn't release the first Mario Party is because of lawsuits. Why they haven't released the third beats me. So this is one of the older ones available. I bought this originally on the Wii side, and then I upgraded it here recently because my goddaughter was spending the night the same week this came out on Virtual Console for Wii U. So she played it and made me play it. Mario Kart 64. I've got to go through this and unlock. I mean, I have the Luigi start screen. That's not the Luigi start. The Luigi start screen. That means I must have mastered it at one time. Here's F-Zero X. Why not? I did play the hell out of this a few weeks ago. Mario Party DS. My wife and I bought this, and there's just a really long story mode. After that, I left. And it shouldn't be like that. Star Fox 64. Do I have the original cartridge for this? You know what? This was a misunderstanding. And I wanted to buy it on 3DS, and somehow we ended up downloading it. This actually replaces the Wii. We had it on the Wii side, and this actually replaces that. Also replaces the original N64 cartridge. But when I was mentioning Star Fox 64, somehow it ended up getting this version. Nostalgia glasses off, this game wasn't as much fun as I remembered in 1990. Same with Kung Fu Heroes. Came out around the same time. I remember renting these and loving them. Here's Gradius for the TurboGrafx. I can use the same up, up, down, down, left, right, BA start, which on a TurboGrafx controller would be up, up, down, down, left, right, 1-2 start, I believe. And I enjoyed it, but, you know, I'm not dying. And there are days I do want to play Gradius or R-Type, or Xevious, or Space Invaders. Oh, I love this game. Ghostblade HD is a bullet hell. Just like Jamestown, I played on the PS4. Bug Princess, or Ushahima Futari, or whatever it's called. Ushahisa-sama. I love it. Much better than that Gaia Breaker. I recommend this game. For anyone who owns a Wii U, buy this game. It's not that big of a download. Buy it. It's beautiful. And if you have a PS4, I recommend also buying it there and Jamestown. Here's Ogre Battle 64. You know, I never played it on the... When I had this on the Wii side, I never played it because I was still playing the original Ogre Battle. Newtopia. Ghost and Goblins. Well, Newtopia is the Zelda of the TurboGrafx, but I already addressed that. Ghost and Goblins. Get the knife. Actually, I was playing this the other day. I tried to get the knife, and I couldn't get the knife because the knife appeared in a grave or a tombstone. How was I supposed to get the knife because it was a tombstone? This game will drive you up a wall like Bubble Bobble. One of the best Bomberman. If you want my recommendation, the Bomberman games I recommend is Bomberman 93, 94, Super Bomberman, Mega Bomberman, Bomberman Saturn Bomberman, and Bomberman World. Here's Bomberman 64. It's alright. Fond memories. But not... Fond memories of being drunk and playing it, to tell you the truth. Mario Strikers Charged. I am actually impressed about how cartoonishly good this soccer game is. It's no FIFA. It's no PES, which I would love to get the PESs for the original Wii. But, no, I haven't yet. I haven't played this yet. It's called Swap Fire. This was a free download advertised on Nintendo Life and my Nintendo News within a week of this recording. And the last game that I have purchased was PokéPark Wii, Pikachu's Adventure. And this is... It was $8 less of what I saw the cheapest copy at, though I see this game is usually over... closer to $50 used. And I hope they release the second one. This is just... for me to when kids are over or whatever. Like, now, I'm not going to go into the physical games I own. That would be too numerous. That'd be too much. So I hope that you enjoyed this. I made a PS3 version of this. This is combining the Wii with the Wii U. And apparently I own Lode Runner on both sides. There must be a reason I kept the old Lode Runner. Probably either my high score or I'm really far in the game. Anyways, copyforbinky@gmail.com. Okay, this is addendum or something like that. Where it's added on to the end of a book. I know you're probably thinking this isn't a book, but in a way it is. This is what new books look like. The first three games at the top left, you already know, Altered Beast, Blue Clues, Alex Kidd. Maybe not Alex Kidd. Did I say Blue's Clues? I meant Blue's Journey. So those three I think I've already covered. And, yeah, here's Mappy. You know anything about Mappy? Mappy was this attempt to make another mascot in Namco, but today they're happily behind Pac-Man. So I don't get the whole thing behind Mappy, but the idea is to bounce on these whatever, trampoline, recover stolen loot. As long as the mouse is bouncing, the cat can't get to the mouse. Flicky is a similar game in a lot of ways. But Mappy's just, it's okay, and with practice it can be good, but it's not really for everybody. I have fond memories of it, I guess. Maybe I don't. I don't know. I never, let's be honest, I think I've only seen a mapping machine in South Korea. I don't think I've ever seen a mapping machine anywhere else. But there's Mappy. Also, the Tower of Aga, I think that's what it's called. This, I get confused. See, there's another game, and I think it's by Konami, where this weirdly animated guy, like his arm rotates with the sword as the player moves the character about left or right. So I think that's what I thought. This is more of a slow-paced gauntlet, a little more strategy left from the action. Comparing it to that gauntlet is much more fun. And then there's Lords of Thunder. Lords of Thunder is the sequel to Gate of Thunder, or Gates of Thunder, depending on who you talk to. And with Lords of Thunder, I think one of these was released or translated over to Sega CD, and I think that Konami should have authorized Hudson Soft to bring all their stuff over to the Sega CD, but there's a lot of problems there. Sega CD Universe, Vampire Mike, he used to get to talk about that. King's Knight, that's a Squaresoft title. Some elements have popped up in later games like Final Fantasy. In a way, it's an offshoot of Final Fantasy or whatever. Similar to more Commando or Gunsmoke or Secret Commando or Rambo or something like that. It's a shooter. It absolutely is a shooter. It's just not in space on the ground. So there it is. Moina's blog, I believe it's by David Crane. David Crane, the guy who created Pitfall and many, many other games. Him and Dan Kitchen are like legendary Atari programmers. Their name frequently appears. The Moina's blog is a unique case. It's been remade recently, I think, for all major systems. At least I know. I have a Wii version. And I saw it for sale on GOG or Steam or something like that. And it's rather unique. Angry Video Game Nerd actually likes the game, too. Here's a game I've never played, and just based on the funny title, I bought it. And this money all comes from YouTube. YouTube money was used entirely to buy what you're saying here. Princess Tomato in the Salad Kingdom. I don't know anything about it. I never played it. Sounds like something my wife would play, actually. So, maybe it's like Mappy or something, or maybe it's unique, like a boy in his blob. Enduro Racer, that's just kind of for me to kick back once in a while, whatever. I do that with games like Burnout, Paradise, and Need for Speed, Most Wanted You. I just kind of kick back. Driver, there's a video of me just kicking back and talking while playing Driver. Wonder Boy and Monster Land. I don't think I'm familiar with this either. I don't think I've ever played it. But I didn't want to come off so, I don't know, anti-Wonder Boy like I did, bashing it and calling it a Adventure Island ripoff. Well, the first one is. I mean, the first one is not a ripoff. The first one is Adventure Island, as Adventure Island is it. So there we go. Next up is Fantasy Zone 2. Since I kind of like the first one, actually, and in all honesty, I like the Indian version because that's what I grew up playing. Having the Sega version and everything. Fantasy Zone is a unique shooter, so I assume if I like the first one, I'll like the second. Now, I know the whole thing. Don't assume nothing in life. It's my life, personally, it's not really affecting anybody. I'll assume that. I just won't assume anything about anyone else's life. But I assume I will like Fantasy Star 2. That's my best guess, anyway. And next is Alex Kidd, The Lost Stars. I haven't played this. I'm not really a big Alex Kidd fan. I do have two Alex Kidd games, so I'm wondering if I would enjoy it, though. The problem with Alex Kidd, let's compare Alex Kidd to Mascots before, because he's been retired more or less for Sonic the Hedgehog. When comparing Alex Kidd to Pac-Man, Pac-Man was allowed by, I believe, Hanna-Barbera, but I could be wrong, could be Ruby Spears, whoever did the Pac-Man cartoon back in the 80s, allowed Pac-Man to have a family. There is Ms. Pac-Man, so forth and so on. There's a lot of personality there. People can relate to Pac-Man. He's a universal character with universal problems. Not a black guy, he's not a white guy, he's not an Oriental or anything, or Latino or whatever. He's Pac-Man. He can be whatever the voice actor needs him to be, and the setting is generic. It's a city. That's it. Pac-Man appeals. Mario, we all know Mario is allegedly an Italian plumber from Brooklyn, who has to deal with Scapelli. But with Mario, the whole appeal, at least in the cartoon form of Mario, is that yes, he is Italian. He plays that to the hilt. But that's okay. Everyone can be Mario. He's not this god-like person. And I don't mean that in the way these ignorant video game anime people put it. I mean, he's not chiseled, as in Hercules or Zeus or any of the other Thor, whatever. I mean, he is a fat guy with weight problems that we can all relate to, and facial hair and everything like that. I understand the facial hair was a decision because Mario had problems, but, you know, there you go. The other mascots, Barkster, and Arrow the Acrobat, and Bubsy, they all, again, universal appeal. The problem with Alex Kidd and why Sonic the Hedgehog made a much better mascot was that Alex Kidd is a monkey. Not like Super Monkey Ball, those have appeal, but a monkey. Alex Kidd is a monkey. I don't know. Does that come off as offensive or insulting? I mean, it's definitely insulting. I don't want to play the monkey. It's bad enough that being what I am of extremely mixed races, I've been called a yellow monkey before in the past as a child. And it's not really anything I can imagine. You know, they made this for Japan. I mean, by Japanese for Japanese. I don't get it. I don't understand the whole thing. Wonder Boy has more appeal, blonde hair and stuff like that, at least from the first game. Like I said, I haven't played any other Wonder Boy because I don't own it. That's why I think Alex Kidd is an overall failure. And yeah, Wonder Boy was a second attempt at a mascot, which Sega backed up both of these guys at the same time, and I don't know. So I'm looking forward to actually playing Wonder Boy 3. I see a castle in the background there on the title screen, or icon, Wii Channel icon. So, you know, I'm looking forward to that. And then finally, I addressed this game earlier. I thought I had this on Virtual Console. I really thought I did. The Legend of Kage, or Legend of Cage, as we all said, because, you know, Song of the K is cool. I really thought, what I found out later is I own the original cartridge. So, Stunner, myself, I guess. Stone Cold Stunner. I like this game, though. This is an early Nintendo game. It's repetitive. There's just certain things that I like about it. The music gets to me after a while, but I don't mind the music. I like, it's also, it's related to, Revenge of the Ninja, the anime game, the anime Dragon's Lair. It's related to that, right down to the design of the characters, actually. His name is Hayate there, not Kage. So, whatever. Both made by Taito, I believe. But, the Sega CD version that I own Revenge of the Ninja. I don't know. It's by renovation, that's the thing. But I think it's by Taito in the arcade. Okay, if I'm starting to have trouble talking, that's my back medication starting to creep into my brain. So, I'm going to go ahead and call it here. And again, this is an addendum. So that's coffeeforbinky@gmail.com everywhere, more or less. But, you know, if you need to email me or whatever, or send money my way via Patreon so we can get more games. I'm about to launch two different formats of the games after, or maybe during what I'm doing right now. One format, we already have the streaming on the PS4 format. I just want to address this real quick. The other format is where I'm going to be featuring one game from my download. I also have the Xbox 360 that I need to do. And I'm not doing the PS4 just because I don't like how it's organized right now. So I'll get to the PS4 later, but I am going to show off the Xbox 360. Oh, excuse me for yawning. The Xbox 360 games. In a follow-up video to this. Now, from there, we're going to start playing these games. I'll do my best to go in the order that you see, but I don't know. And I don't know how. I'm thinking of doing two videos per game, one game. One video will have me talking about the game, and the other one will have me just playing it, I guess. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. And any suggestions is open here. I haven't even started on this format. I will be using also a lot of these games for 10 games in 10 minutes, which will also be getting a name change soon. You know, deal yet, just yet, or exposed, whatever the case may be. So, again, that's coffeeforbinky@gmail.com. And also, that's the coffeeforbinky@patreon. It would be really nice if you all could help me out. I really want to make a good show for you, the audience, but, you know, I can't do that. You know, and like I said, once I get a full-time job, I don't know if these things will be on the table anymore, or they'll be real sporadic. Like my friend, Hello, I'm Pizza, who does the PSA compilation and blog posts and stuff. He's real busy. He's a busy man, and he gets the thing when he gets the thing. You know, I wish I could give you something in the long line of production quality like Kim Justice or even Razor Fist or even Gaming History Sources, Let's Compare and everything. It's just, I don't have the time or resources to do that because I am just stuck on really old technology. You know, just a whole bunch of personal things happen with that because I'm trying to keep these things afloat, but you know, when you don't have any money coming in, you don't have any money coming in, and that's the truth. And what little money I do get, if you can actually estimate how much all this would cost on the Wii Virtual Console, you will know that, you know, this is everything here is real stretched out to the max. And you know, I'm doing this because I want to give you guys something to see, something unique, something different. And you can either watch my fighting game matches. So once those are done, those are done. I don't know what I'm going to do. I still have eons of footage. But once those are done, those are done. So anyway, enjoy out there. I'll say it again, coffeeforbinky@gmail.com or go to Patreon.